Mr. Taru, in this calculus video, we're going to be taking the derivative of y is equal to x raised to the power of sine of x. If you have not seen one of these problems that have a variable base and a variable exponent, well, basically, you're going to have to figure it out because we have a rule, which is the derivative of u raised to the n power, a variable base, and a fixed exponent is equal to n times u to the n minus 1 power times u prime. And we have the derivative of a to the u, where the now base is fixed as opposed to the variable, is equal to the natural log of a times a to the u times u prime. Basically, you need to change this base a to base e through some kind of logarithmic work and come out with your formula here, your identity, your rule for taking that derivative. However, here we have a variable base and a variable exponent, and that means that we're going to need to work through this if you want to do it as cleanly as possible, unlike the video I made years ago, which still involved logarithms, but we're going to take the natural log of both sides, use the power property of logarithms to expand this so we don't have a function raised by another function, take the derivative implicitly, and then ultimately arrive at an answer for y prime or dy dx. And this is what it's going to look like. Take the natural log of both sides. Then remember that, of course, we get exponents from logarithms, so we basically have an exponent raised by an exponent, so we're going to use the power property of logarithms to bring this sine of x out as a coefficient. The natural log of y is equal to the sine of x times the natural log of x, and now see, we have the multiplication or the product of two functions, and then we can go back to using that product rule for taking derivatives. We're going to take the derivative of both sides of this equation implicitly. We're going to take the derivative with respect to x, that is our original sort of independent variable. And over here with the natural log of y, we're not just going to get 1 over y because we're not taking the derivative with respect to y, it's with respect to x. So we have over here on the left 1 over y times dy dx. And on the right hand side, using the product rule, we have the sine times the derivative of the natural log of x, which is 1 over x. And then plus the second factor, the natural log of x times the derivative times the derivative of sine, which is cosine, what we have to add there. So we have first times the derivative of the second, plus the second times the derivative of the first. And the derivative of sine is cosine of x. And that's it, we're practically done. All we have to do now is solve for y prime by multiplying both sides of the equation by y. But we don't really want a first derivative that, you know, has that original independent variable of x and also have it be in terms of y. That'd be like writing the second derivative with the first derivative notation still in our answer. So we're going to take y out and replace it with what it's equal to, which of course is x raised to the sine of x power. That is all there is to taking the derivative of a function where both the base and the exponent are functions, are variables, not just where we have a variable base and a fixed exponent, or a fixed base and variable exponent. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.